Today, I'm going to give you a brief overview of our supply chain SaaS roadmap, discuss why we are so excited to be investing in this space, and what types of opportunities we are most focused on. Now, you don't need me to tell you that supply chain and logistics is an absolutely massive market at nearly $10 trillion. But what's impressive is not only does it represent over 10% of global GDP, but it is also growing at a healthy clip, adding over $600 billion of market value every year. In addition, the industry remains extremely complex and offline, in large part due to the globally distributed nature of supply chains and the number of intermediaries that need to collaborate to make them function. Most large enterprises still manage supply chain data in on-prem ERP-like systems that are difficult to integrate with, leading to many data silos. And despite these investments in expensive systems of record, 50% of the largest enterprise shippers in the US still rely on some combination of email and spreadsheets to manage supply chains day to day. So why are we so excited to be focusing on supply chain now? The reason is we are seeing two primary trends that are driving opportunities in the space. First, the repeated and massive shocks to the global supply chains, which even before the pandemic and the associated boom in e-commerce included things like Brexit, which created huge supply chain issues in Europe, and the US-China trade tensions, which forced many importers to start thinking about diversifying supply chains before the pandemic even started. This means that supply chain resilience has finally become a C-level concern for many large enterprises, similar to the way that other categories like cybersecurity became C-suite priorities after similar shocks. The second trend is that we're starting to see increased digitization, both in terms of the amount of data being created throughout supply chains and the emergence of cloud-based systems of record and data aggregators, which we believe are starting to make it much easier to build modern software applications in the space. As we mentioned, the recent shocks to the system have had the result of making supply chain resilience a top priority for all large companies. According to a McKinsey survey of enterprise supply chain leaders, 93% cite plans to increase resilience. And surprisingly, only 11% of leaders cited budget constraints as a blocker to supply chain transformation. So we believe that now that supply chain resilience is such a high priority for many executive teams, we will see a substantial step up in supply chain technology investment from large enterprises. If we look at the current TAM for core supply chain software categories, it represents about a $25 billion market today. But to be clear, this is just limited to the incumbent enterprise supply chain management modules, which include things like transportation management systems, warehouse management systems, and network planning software. All very established software categories, which are still growing at nearly 12% annually. We think the growth in this legacy market is indicative of the broader increase in software spend that we expect to see across the industry. But we are much more interested in the emergence of entirely new software categories that we believe will be created over the coming years. We think that over the next 10 years, supply chain software market broadly can easily expand to well north of $100 billion of SaaS revenue, driven in large part by a wave of new software products that will be sold into this market. On the second trend of increasing digitization, over the past decade, companies have made substantial investments throughout supply chain in terms of the hardware infrastructure that is digitizing the physical movement of goods. This includes everything from IoT sensors, industrial cameras, asset trackers, to cloud-connected POS systems that feed data back into demand planning systems, and even satellite data to track ships and assets. This data is now being aggregated by companies in a new category of supply chain visibility middleware from providers like Project 44 and Forkites, and cloud-based systems of record like CargoWise. Ultimately, we are excited about this because we think this unlocks opportunities for a new category of intelligence and application layer SaaS companies to be built on top of these systems. We like to draw the loose analogy to the evolution of the fintech ecosystem, where middleware infrastructure providers like Plaid made it much easier to build modern application layer software on top of legacy banking systems. We are hopeful that we are now at a similar inflection point in the supply chain industry. Our thesis is that we have reached a tipping point in supply chain digitization, which, coupled with strong macro tailwinds, will enable a new wave of data infrastructure, workflow automation, and collaboration platforms that will ultimately create multiple billion-dollar software categories in this industry. This is a market map of the supply chain software categories that we have been tracking closely. We have tried to focus largely on SaaS solutions, which is why you don't see some of the tech-enabled service providers on this map, such as digital freight brokerages, or some of the more capital-intensive and asset-heavy categories like autonomous vehicles, and warehousing solutions. In particular, there are a few categories that we have been most focused on, which include workflow automation and optimization, digital bookings platforms, supply chain intelligence and collaboration, and we have an emerging thesis around the need for developer tools devoted specifically to the needs of supply chain logistics companies. So far, we've made a few investments along these themes, including Shippo, the leading provider of multi-carrier shipping rates for e-commerce vendors, Cargo One, a digital bookings platform for the air freight industry, Vector AI, workflow automation for the freight forwarding industry, and Optimal Dynamics, a decision optimization engine for large trucking carriers and enterprise shippers. To summarize what we are looking for, we are focused on investing in software that can help to streamline manual workflows and optimize supply chain operations. We believe it's critical that any products in the space are designed to embrace and extend legacy systems of record and provide seamless onboarding. Ideally, we are looking for companies that can sell into large enterprise shipper budgets, but increasingly, we're investing in solutions that are selling into carriers and service providers where they can demonstrate compelling ROIs for these operators. We think this is an industry where founding teams need to either have deep industry experience or surround themselves with people that do in order to truly understand the challenges their customers face. And finally, we're targeting products that have sticky, long-term value, not just one-time cost savings, and can scale with their customers over time.